Radio 1 Podcast.
Radio 1 Podcast.
Download them for free at bbc.co.uk/radio1.
Now. The Scott Mills Daily.
This is Radio 1.
Hello, Scott. Hello, Kelvin, Joe, Kurt, Louise, Paul and Tim, who went to the darts, which we've all been watching over the weekend on TV. It's brilliant. And as you know, I'm quite good at it.
Oh, I spoke to them.
Yeah.
On Saturday morning, yeah.
Now, they went to Lakeside and they made Scott Mills masks while they were watching the darts. And they've sent some pictures.
Have they sent the pictures to you?
They are.
Brilliant.
Why would you do that? That's them at the darts in Lakeside, all with masks and me on. Okay.
The one on the right actually does look quite like you.
Thanks.
I've just been talking to the people at Lakeside off of darts because Chopper gave me a contact.
Yeah.
And I've managed to sort something out for you.
Oh, no.
On Thursday.
Oh, why do I do this every single time?
On Thursday.
I don't want to play darts.
You're going to have the time of your life.
But I was only good at it once in a pub in Southampton, and that was might have been beginner's luck. I know I've been giving it all the I'm brilliant at darts on the radio, but
you need a bit more confidence, a bit more bravado if you're going to make it in the darts world, I think.
Right, so what have you sorted, please?
On Thursday, you're going to be playing darts against
Where?
Bobby George at Lakeside. And Ray Stubbs is going to be there as well. So I'm coming.
It's good, though.
I guess, is it a round of darts?
No, it's a leg.
I play a leg of darts with Barry
George. It's a round
George.
Of golf. Do you want to do that next?
No, I don't. See, this has happened before.
A round of golf with Brucey.
This happened before with the getting on the horse thing. I said it, horse riding looked easy.
You don't have to go on a horse.
See, that is, I think that's still got to be worse than a round of darts with Barry George.
A leg of darts with Bobby George, not Barry George.
Who's Barry George?
Oh,
actually, I know who Barry George is. So it's Bobby George.
This is Lakeside 2008.
It's going to be me.
So, ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? Ladies and gentlemen, let's play
dance.
Keep your hands clapping. Please welcome
Scott Robert Mills.
Oh no. This is on Thursday.
Yeah, so you've got to think about your costume.
What? Why do you have to wear a costume?
Well, so they have capes, don't they?
Oh, actually,
you could have a cape.
I've just read that Barry George is known for coming out to the
Bobby
George is now known to come out to the sound of We Are the Champions, wearing a crown and a cloak and holding a candelabra.
So you can't do that because that'd be nicking his axe.
Right.
So you need something different. Maybe you walk on with a bottle of wine and a bottle of tan.
All right.
And a
feather duster.
And a duster.
Maybe I could wear one glove.
And your one glove, yeah.
Yeah, I've got a bit of Bobby George here now.
Nine darts. How often do the players hit them in practice, Bob?
Oh, they do nine darts loads of times in practice. It gives you a buzz in practice when even I've done it. So, yeah. But to do it up there, you do a nine dart, you get 52 grand. That's called a lovely jumping nine dart.
It's £1,000 for every week of this year.
Oh, it's lovely.
Oh, it's lovely. He says that a lot.
Ton 80s for show, doubles for dough.
Oh, it's lovely.
Oh, it's lovely.
Oh, it's lovely.
I've just checked out his house on YouTube. He must be rich.
It's good, isn't it?
It is. His house is something else. He built it himself, apparently.
Yeah.
And this is Barry George's house, like 18 bedroom, Bobby George's house, 18 bedroom house in Essex, and it is amazing. And it's like loads of darts memorabilia in there, and it's in the shape of a dart. It's lovely.
Oh, it's lovely.
It really is. So I'll be playing with him on Thursday.
On Thursday, yeah.
The Masters champion starts his campaign for the world title. And he looked good, didn't he?
Oh, played lovely.
Lovely.
He didn't give John a chance. Not a chance. Nearing up every shot. Bang. Just like he did on the World Masters.
Bang. Lovely. Now, am I allowed to outbling him on Thursday?
Yes, you are.
Because
yeah.
I've noticed he wears about 10 watches on the outside of his shirt.
He's the king of bling.
Isn't he? And a massive, like, gold chain as well around his neck. He looks the part. So I'd like to have, Laura, if you could go down the market or something, I'd like at least 15 watches on the outside of my shirt so I can kind of be up against Bobby.
You could wear one of your fancy dress outfits that you have in your wardrobe.
Which one?
The Nazi one.
The Nazi one. No, they'd love that. Let's play darts. Oh, look, it's a Nazi. Anyway, so that's on for Thursday. Me and Bobby.
The Scott Mills Daily.
Right.
Inquisitive.
Had an email from a girl called Chloe in Stevenage, right? Now, she's just come back from quite a nice New Year break with some of her family and friends in France. Been snowboarding, right? Now, she's in the airport. I don't know what airport. France airport. Right? On the way back home, okay? After having a week away. She was there all over New Year, right? Mm-hmm. She probably had a cheese and ham baguette or three, because that's all you can get in Europe, I find. Cheese and ham again? Oh, brilliant. And anyway, so she's on the plane, on the runway at France airport. Yeah. And you know when they're about to... You're kind of waiting for them to start the engine and everyone's kind of getting on the plane, aren't they?
I hope they'd have started the engine if they're on the runway.
Well, they're just waiting. They're waiting.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
And they play that kind of, that music to calm you down a bit, don't they?
Yes.
Like, you know, like with the little tannoy, they get that kind of like quite, it's normally quite soothing music. Just
occasionally
to,
it's top loader.
It is often top loader, I find.
Yeah.
But, so, you know, it's kind of soothing music just to calm any nervous passengers that might be on the plane and a bit scared about taking off. Anyway, Chloe is not the best flyer at the best of times, right? And she notices they're playing this as they're waiting to take off. Now, that's not the best song to hear as you're taking off, is it? You don't want to hear that. Are they having a laugh or what? Flying without wings? Flying without an engine that's about to fall off? That kind of made her feel even more nervous. The worst song that you could ever hear, maybe, as you're about to take off from France airport. You've had your cheese and ham baguette, right? You're a bit scared of flying, right? This comes on. Am I going to die?
I'm flying without wings.
Sorry to hear about that, Chloe. She doesn't say what airline it was at France airport either.
Radio 1 Podcasts.
Britney Spears news, she's okay. I don't know if you've been following this as much as I have over the weekend.
I don't think anybody's been following it as much as you have.
But she's all
You're
right.
You're obsessed.
Wasn't it scary though? Because I don't know if you were listening last week. We were doing Miles' show for a couple of days and we were on air when the ambulance was like taking her from her house when she was stretched out from her house to the hospital in Los Angeles. And we were a little bit worried for a minute, weren't we?
You got very... excited.
When we sat here the other day, it was scary. It was just like the Every Time video a little bit, but played out in real life. Have you seen that? Where she has like some kind of incident.
Is that where she's in the bath?
In the bath, right?
Yeah.
And then she gets rescued by that bloke who used to be in films but isn't anymore. And then she dies.
Right.
Sorry if I spoiled the plot to the Every Time video if you've not seen it before. But she hasn't died. She is okay. Imagine if she did though, if she went, that'd be terrible. We'd be in mourning, wouldn't we? For like days, non-stop, like somber music for months on this show. Probably only on this show.
You would. Could you stop the wee thing? It's more about you, really.
And Miles and like Joe and Edith would be normal music, and then at four, it's 4 o'clock in time for Scott Mills. For 3 hours, just this show.
Yeah.
Now, she's okay because Dr. Phil went to see her. Do you know who he is?
I don't know who Dr. Phil is. Right, Dr. Phil.
He's really famous in America for offering advice. He has like a big TV show there. He sticks his nose in everywhere, to be honest.
Is he their equivalent of Dr. Mark?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That kind of crossed with that woman that used to be on this morning, Denise.
Oh.
It's like her going around to your house.
That's an impressive cross between Denise and Dr. Mark.
How do you want me to help you, love? Her. And maybe a bit of Dr. Raj Perso.
Oh.
Yeah.
Lots of qualities all rolled into one.
Only Dr. Phil speaks a bit like the bloke on South Park. Okay.
Drugs are bad, Brittany. Okay.
Thing is, Brittany had no idea he was turning up at all. Dr. Phil just turned up unannounced.
Hello, Brittany. I'm here to help. Okay.
But she's fine. She's fine. Also, another thing, right? That picture of her looking a little bit wild-eyed on the stretcher. Yeah.
Yeah.
Still would, wouldn't you?
Radio 1 Podcasts.
Radio 1 Podcast. Podcast. This is Radio 1.
Yes, it's 5:43. Also, putting Final Destination on as the in-flight movie, that's not good either, is it? Hello to Adam, who was on a flight recently, and this was the song they were playing just as they're about to take off.
I keep on falling.
Oh, brilliant. That makes me feel brilliant. Thanks for that. the engines are starting up.
I keep on falling.
Okay. Oh, here's a good one. Now, you wouldn't think the editor's Racing Rats would be a bad one to hear as you're about to take off. You're on the runway at France Airport. But then you hear this.
Cheery.
That's not. Hello to everyone that was on a ferry once. There's a lot of people from France to England, and they kept playing the Celine Dion theme from Titanic.
This is a podcast from BBC Radio 1.
Now, I've got an email from Daniel, who's got a bit of a predicament at the moment. He lives in Stoke-on-Trent, if you care. Is he normal? Okay.
Yes, right. Plenty of people do live there.
No, not just because he lives in Stoke.
Oh, you don't want to upset.
I don't mean that.
Oh, you've upset people in
Stoke. No, right, that's not what I'm talking about. I'm asking, is he normal? Is he normal? Because what I'm about to say,
okay.
Listen,
all right.
It's just a thing that he lives in Stoke-on-Trent. It doesn't matter to the story at all, okay? He's been seeing a girl for a couple of months, and he's got a bit of a problem in the bedroom department.
Right.
Right, you know what it's like. Round at Suzanne's house, the girl he's been seeing for a couple of months.
I don't, but go on.
Right, well, she's got that dog, hasn't she?
Okay.
Right? So, you know, it's a fairly new relationship. Daniel and Suzanne are in the living room the other night, having a little bit of, you know, kiss and a cuddle, a bit of kissy time on the sofa. Mm-hmm. And Daniel looks over her shoulder, and there's quite a big dog there, which is called a Weimaraner? Those grey dogs, quite nice grey kind of dogs, okay. Silver dogs. Right, and... You know that thing that dogs do sometimes where they kind of tilt their head to one side?
Before now, they bite you?
Yeah. Mm. Now, Daniel asks Suzanne to take the dog out while they're, you know, on the sofa, having a bit of a special time together. Mm-hmm. And she's like, no, she loves a dog. No, it's cold. Now, it's like a one-room flat, this, like a studio flat. Yeah. So she kind of bluntly refuses to let the dog go out. So Daniel has to continue, you know, with the... With the kissy
whilst
time.
The dog watches.
Whilst the dog kind of watches. Kind of tilts his head to one side a little bit. Ugh. Now, that would put you off a little bit.
Yeah, definitely.
Daniel wants to know, I don't know why people email... Why do they email us? Out of everyone else they could talk to about this. Oh, I know, I'll email Scott Mills. He'll know. Daniel wants to know, is it wrong to be a little bit put off with him and his girlfriend there on the sofa and the dog watching as they kind of get off with each other?
No, perfectly normal. She has to choose between him and the dog.
What, so he should put his foot down a little bit and go, no,
yeah, he should. Oh, God.
Before we continue kissing, Suzanne, you need to get the dog out of the room.
Oh, I couldn't think of anything worse than kissy-kissy with an animal watching.
Right. But loads of people must do it, mustn't they? The animal just is there in the room.
No.
No, it must happen.
I'd be so scared.
But seriously, I bet we'll get loads of texts on this now. 8199. Do you have a special time with your partner whilst the pet... Your pet is in the room.
Oh,
I bet they do.
Wrong.
Well, I bet a lot of people don't even think, if they're getting a bit carried away, to just, you know, ask the dog or the cat to leave. Excuse me, I'm going to kiss my girlfriend now. Cat, could you just go?
But they might jump on you or bite you or something.
No, that's just because you're scared of dogs. You think they're always going to bite you or jump on you. I don't think they'd want to get anywhere near you. I'm just saying, is it wrong if they watch? And where does it stop? I mean, what about if you've got, like... fish in the room?
No, that's fine.
Why is that fine then?
Because they only have 2 second memories, so they won't.
No, it's about 8 seconds, isn't it?
I don't know. I don't
think so. See, I think I might have done something with a fish.
With some
fish in the room, because I've got fish in my living room at the moment. But right. It's like an 8 second, 6 second memory in it. So, like you say, they won't remember a thing. But fish is
so
all right.
So you've had kissy kissy in front of a goal in front of a fish.
I have. Yeah, but that didn't bother me at the time. Because like, it's a lot of hassle moving the whole tank out, isn't it? But I think with... But you're saying with a dog or a cat... No, what else? What else is it acceptable with?
It's not acceptable. A fish is just about allowable.
So it's allowed with fish, not allowed with dogs.
Did the fish look embarrassed the following morning?
I didn't check. I was busy.
Did it kind of go under its bridge and avert its eyes from you? Hide behind the plankton.
No eye contact. No eye contact.
What I witnessed last night. Radio 1 Podcasts.
Podcast. You know Hannah Montana? So you don't get this on the rest of Radio 1, do you?
Yeah, I know. I know of Hannah Montana.
We bring you all the breaking Britney news stories, and also we talk about Hannah Montana. Yeah, you don't get that anywhere else.
No, I don't know personally, but I know who you mean.
Now, if you're over the age of, let's say, 25, you might not know who Hannah Montana is, but she's a massive, massive star in America. And here's a unique selling point, right? By day, she's like a normal schoolgirl, right? Mm. And then by night, she is a huge pop star called Hannah Montana. That's how it works. It's a Disney thing.
Yeah. Right?
Now, she's on tour at the moment. Loads of kids in the UK love a bit of Hannah Montana as well. And this is the biggest thing in the States. Like, no one can get tickets for this show at all. It's the most massive thing. You love it, don't you?
Yeah, she's a bit like Hilary Duff.
Yeah. She's a bit like Britney before it all went wrong. Like Britney, how she used to be. She's got all that to come, Hannah Montana. She's got the stretcher. It's coming. About 10 years' time. Anyway, no one can get tickets for this show. Okay? And someone has kind of, on her tour, has captured this interesting moment on stage, okay, on the camera phone. Mm. Right? This is a shot of the gig. This is Hannah Montana on stage. This is on YouTube at the moment. Now, I'd like you to watch this, Chopper, okay?
Yeah.
Now, keep watching. The girl in the pink, that's Hannah Montana. Something strange will happen. Describe it, okay? She's on stage singing now. Describe what happens.
She runs off with a coat over her head.
Yeah.
And then some kind of lump comes on. In a blonde wig and a pink coat to keep going.
Yeah.
While she's gone off, presumably, for a fag. or maybe, because obviously she's wholesome, a costume change.
That's what it is, probably.
But the person that appears to have come on is about twice her size.
That's right. Fake Hannah Montana is going on. Right, so, this is on YouTube, as I say. She gets covered in a blanket, right? Mm. Bit like murderers do when they get pushed into the van.
Yes, you know? It's just like that, yeah.
And someone in exactly the same outfit comes on and carries on doing the rest of the song, only with a wig over their face. Now, I'm sorry, that is a bloke. That's a bloke. You're right when you said it's a lump.
It's a lump,
right?
Yeah.
That's a man pretending to be Hannah Montana with a wig over his face, pretending that he's the actual person.
That could mess a lot of her fans up.
Really could.
If they see that.
Yeah, it could.
They're going to think that she can't dance.
Are you watching it again now?
I am, yeah.
Right, she goes off.
It's the most unsubtle thing.
The blanket gets put over her head. Then Hannah Montana reappears, but it's clearly not her. Why does she have to rush off, do you think?
I've told you she's gone for a fag.
I want one of those at my gigs.
what a double.
Yeah. Like maybe for the difficult last hour at Butlin's in Minehead, right? I'll go off.
You go off under a blanket.
Under a blanket. Someone else comes on with a bottle of wine and some sunglasses on.
Oranged up to the hilt.
Yeah.
Away you go.
Oh, it's Scott Mills. Wig on, right? To obscure my face. Good, eh? I don't know why she's done it. Check it out. It's on YouTube, and we'll try and link it to our pages at Radio 1 Online. But it is truly remarkable. And if you were actually at the gig, surely you would be like, something's definitely up there. that's not her. It's a man. Radio 1 Podcasts. Radio 1 Podcasts. Podcast. George?
Yeah.
Right, we were just talking about pets, right? When they're in the room at the same time, you know, when you're...
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Right. Have you done that?
No.
Do you ask the cat to leave?
Of course.
Do you say in French, could you leave, please, cat? Do you say that?
No, I say it in English.
Right, what? Okay, and the cat does what?
Leaves.
Right, do you say anything?
I leave now.
The cat has never stayed in the room.
Never stayed in the room.
Well, not that I know of.
Right, okay. What about sitting on the toilet? Is that okay?
Yeah, that's fine.
Right, okay. So your cat or dog can watch you on the loo. But not during sex time.
That's okay.
What happens if you let the cat out, but then he goes onto the windowsill and looks through the window?
As long as he's looking through the window.
Kind of peeping Tom cat.
Peeping Tom cat. Radio 1 Podcast. Radio 1 Podcast.
podcast. That was the Scott Mills Daily. Why not try the best of Chris Moyles? Available now to download for free at bbc.co.uk/radio1.